Hi, hello and welcome to my channel. Hope all are doing good. Like, share, subscribe and click on the bell icon for the latest notification of the upcoming videos. The topic covered in this session is seating arrangement. Okay, it is one of the interesting topic of reasoning, and the best part of seating arrangement question is that if you are able to find the solution for the given statement, then you can easily answer 5 questions within seconds. But the worst part is at times you will not able to form the solution so easily. So the only trick to solve these kind of questions is practice more questions so that you will get an idea of how to look at the question and how to solve it. So practicing is the best part in it. Okay, first I'll just give you an idea of what is seating arrangement. It is nothing but arranging the seats of certain people or objects in certain direction based on some logic. Okay, that is what seating arrangement is. We have few types of seating arrangement. First type is single row arrangement. Single row arrangement is nothing but people facing or standing in a straight line towards one direction. Okay, like north, south, east or west. For example, I'll just give you in a prayer hall how students will be standing. That is one of the example of single row arrangement. Double row arrangement is nothing but we'll have two rows which are parallel that may face inside. That is, people sitting in that parallel rows may face inside or outside. That depends on your question. The best example is people sitting around a rectangular dining table. Next, we have circular arrangement. Third type of arrangement is circular arrangement, where you have two types, facing inside and facing outside. Facing inside is, I'll give you an example, like people sitting around a dining table, facing inside, okay? Facing outside is people playing musical chair, okay? So these are the types of seating arrangement. So I will just give you some ideas or tips and tricks to solve these types of questions. First, check what kind of arrangement it is. Single row, double row or circular, facing inside or outside. Then the direction, that is one of the important thing that you have to notice. Otherwise, you will go wrong with the answers. Then read the statement and find which or all have fixed positions. So based on that, you can fix other positions, okay? Then another thing to note is, if you know a fixed position of some person, then find the statements from the given paragraph relating to him so that you can easily solve the question. So these are some of the tips and tricks to follow. Okay, now I'll just give you some questions which will cover all these types of seating arrangement. Using this, we'll discuss all questions and practice more questions apart from this. So you'll get to know how to solve these kind of questions easily and within seconds. A, B, C, D, E, F and G are sitting in a row facing north. So you draw a line and facing north direction. Next, F is to the immediate right of E. So E is having a fixed position. Immediate right of E means right side of E, since they are facing north. E is fourth to the left of G. So you have to mark G after three positions of E towards left. Okay. C is the neighbor of B and D. With this statement, we can have two possibilities. That is either B, C, D. C should be in center since C is the neighbor of both B and D. Or D, C, B. Okay, these two possibilities are there. Okay, try for BCD in this row. If you put BCD, next statement read, person who is third to the left of D is at one of the end. So third to the left of E is who? G. Okay, is at one end. So the position of G is end position. Okay, in other case, if you check for the possibility of DCB, if you check for that statement, person who is third to the left of D. So DCB third left means it will go away from 7 persons. See, totally there are 7 persons given. We already have some positions fixed. So if we choose DCB, it will go out of 7 positions. So we'll neglect that option. So only BCD suits. So I think we all got all the positions except EA. See, EA. We cannot fix A anywhere towards left side or end, because already we know that G is in the left end corner. So obviously A will be in the right end corner. Okay, now we'll answer the questions. What is the position of A? So extreme right is the answer. Who are the neighbors of B? G and C, which is option B. Next, which of the following statement is not true? So E is to the immediate left of D. That is not true because E is at the right of D. So that is wrong. Who are to the left of C? G and B. So I hope you understood the concept, how to solve these kind of questions and answer the below questions easily. Next, we'll see another example. 5 girls are sitting in a row. Okay. See, if it is not mentioned like which direction, you have to consider it as north. Okay. Rashi is not adjacent to Sulekha or Abba. Wait for the statement. Anuradha is not adjacent to Sulekha. Again, wait. Rashi is adjacent to Monica. Monica is at the middle in the row. See, Monica is, we have 5 girls. So, Monica in the middle means third position. Okay? That is fixed. So, fix her position first. Then, Rashi is adjacent to Monica. So, either Rashi should be in left or right. So, 2 possibilities which I have shown here. Again, now go for next statement. Rashi is not adjacent to Sulekha. So, in the first possibility, you cannot fix Sulekha or Abba in left hand side of Rashi. So, it will go to 4th and 5th position, Sulekha or Abba. Similarly, in the second possibility, Sulekha or Abba cannot be right of Rashi. So, we will fix the position of Sulekha and Abba on 1st and 2nd position. Got my point? Next, Anuradha is not adjacent to Sulekha. So, Anuradha cannot come in 4th and 5th position in 1st possibility and 1st and 2nd position in the 2nd possibility. So, Anuradha's position will be obviously next to, adjacent to Rashi in 1st and the last possibility. Now, the question is, Anuradha is adjacent to whom out of the following? Obviously, it is Rashi. Okay? We don't know Sulekha and Abba's exact position. But our question stops still. So, we need not find that. Okay? So, this is how you have to face this kind of question. Next question. See, this is a circular arrangement. Study the information carefully and answer the question below. 8 friends. So, first put a circle and fix 8 directions, okay, are sitting around a circular table. Around a circular table means all are facing inside, okay. Now, B is second to the left of P. First, fix the position of P. Then, B is second to the left means 1, 2, second to left. Fix B. Once you have fixed the position, you know the for sure that this is the position. Please put a circle around them. So, you'll get an idea like how much you have completed and how much yet to be completed, okay. Next, B is second to the left of P. Who is between H and T? Who is means P is between H and T. So, H and T either should be in between B and P or after P, okay, on the right of P, okay. So, we don't know the confirmed seat of H or T. It may be here or there. Okay, Y is not opposite to P. So, except P, other positions where you can fix Y, first draw that. Except opposite of P, write as Y in the above positions, okay? So, we'll have 3 positions for Y. Now, K is third to the left of B. This you can fix, okay? From B, third left is K. Fix and put a round on that. And N is between T and K. Since we don't know T and H position, but still you check N is between T and K they have given. So obviously the position of T would be right of P. So cancel H there and bring the H down. That is in between B and P. Now I think you got my point. So the only left letter to fix the position is M. Balance all is fixed. Okay. So who is between M and N? So between M and N, we have the position K. Okay. Next question. See, this is double row arrangement. We'll see it. A, B, C, D, E are 5 men sitting in a line facing to the south. Okay. So, facing south. And that is row 1 facing south, A to E. Row 2 facing north, M to Q. Okay. Now, try fixing the positions. B, who is just next to the left of D, is opposite to Q. So fix the position of D, and left of D, just next to left of D, is B. So fix the position of B and D is opposite to Q. So B is opposite to Q. So fix the position of Q down. Okay. C and N are diagonally opposite. Wait for that. E is opposite to next. Check if there is any connection between B, D or Q in your question. Yes. See the fifth statement. P, who is just to the left of Q. So fix the position of P, is opposite to D. That is, P is opposite to D. So we have got four sure positions. That is D, B, P and Q. Okay. M is at one end of the line. So either she'll be in the leftmost or rightmost. Next, fix those positions. Either at leftmost or rightmost end is M. Now, is there any statement related to M? Yes, see the fourth statement. E is opposite to O, who is just next right of M. Check for the M position. See, just next right of M. If she is in the rightmost corner, that is M is in the rightmost corner, then we cannot have one more person to the right of M. So, obviously, M would be in the leftmost corner. Okay. So, we have M's position fixed. Okay. Now, E is opposite to O, who is just next right of M. So, O is right side of M and E is opposite to O. So, we have got these fixed. So, the left C and N are diagonally opposite to each other. Diagonally opposite means either of the corners, okay, from left to right or right to left. We already have left corner, that is second row left corner as M. So, we cannot put N there. So, rightmost corner is N and diagonally opposite is C. I hope we got all the positions fixed. Now, if we have the questions, we'll solve it, okay? So, I don't think that we have to look into questions because you'll obviously find it easily to solve the questions. Next question. In an exhibition, seven cars of different companies are facing to east in the following order. So, towards east, okay? Be careful in it. Okay. Cadillac is next right of Fargo. So, Fargo, fix the position of Fargo first. Then next right means downwards because they are facing towards east, they have given. So, next right downwards is Cadillac. Fargo is fourth to the right of Fiat. So, fix the position of Fiat. Then three gaps. Then fourth position should be Fargo. Then Maruti car is between Ambassador and Bedford. So, we'll have two options, like two possibilities. That is Ambassador, Maruti, Bedford, or Bedford, Maruti and Ambassador. Okay, these are the two possibilities. Okay, so we'll wait for that. Fiat, which is third to the left of Ambassador. So, is at one end. So, Fiat is at one end, they have given. It is third to the left of Ambassador. So, obviously, if it is third to the left of Ambassador, the second position should be like Bedford, then Maruti and then Ambassador. Okay, and the left company is Mercedes, which will go in the end. Okay, so I hope you understood this question. Next question, 12 persons A to Z are sitting, A to F, U to Z are sitting in two parallel rows. A to F are sitting in row 1 facing south direction, okay? And U to Z are sitting in row 2 facing north direction, okay? Now, only one person sits between U and W, who is sitting at the extreme left end of the row. So, U and W in between one person, who is, means W is sitting at the extreme end of the row. So, obviously, second row, fix the first position as W and after which gap and then U, okay? B, who is sitting at the extreme right end. Also, in the first row, extreme right end should be B. Sit second to the left of A. So, fix the position of B and A. C faces the one who is an immediate neighbor of U. So, opposite to U, immediate neighbor of U is C. Okay. So, it can be either left side or right side. So keep that in mind, okay? Then V faces D. Write it separately. V faces D. E, who sits at one of the extreme end of the row, sits third to the right of one who faces Z. So E is at one end. Already we know that B is at the extreme right end. So obviously E should be in the extreme left end, okay? Sits third to the right of the one who faces Z. So one who faces Z, then third position is E, okay? X faces the one who sits second to the left of A. So X faces the one who sits second left of A is B, okay? So I hope we got all the positions. V and D is left. So we already have C in one position and Z in one position. So we cannot fix V and D opposite there. So only left position is the fifth position, so we'll fix their D and B. Okay, hope you understood. Okay, next is a circular table question. See, PQRSTUVW are sitting around a circular table facing center. P sits third to the right of W. So fix the position of W and third position P, fix that also. And third to the left of Q. So Q's position is also fixed. Okay, yes, sits second to the right of T. So first try checking for S and T position, which are all the possibilities except the fixed ones. In the fixed ones, we cannot replace S and T. So except that, check for all the S and T positions where it can be placed. Like S, second right of T. Okay. V sits second to the left of R. Similarly, for V and R also, you just check for all the possibility. T is not the neighbor of Q. Q. So near to Q, up and down, we cannot have T. So check for all other possible positions. While U is neither a neighbor of T, so U cannot be near T, okay? Not W. So U cannot be near W also. So fix the position of U which cannot be near to T or W. So obviously you'll get other. So these are the types of questions you will get. See, starting from P's position, if all the 8 are arranged in alphabetical order in clockwise direction, the seating position of how many members would not change, excluding P. So here it would be 1. Check P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W. That is what they mean. Like they are placed in alphabetical order. For starting from P, excluding P, that means if you don't include P, how many positions? If you check P, Q, R only remain in the same position. S, T, U, V, W all changed. So only R is left. So the option is 1. Who sits second to the left of V? Second to the left of V is R. Yes. Next, which of the following pairs has only one person sitting between them if the counting done in clockwise direction? If you check for this, none of these is the option. Who sits between U and P? U and P, it is S. Okay, 4 of the following are alike in certain way which does not belong to the group. That also you check and write it. The main part is finding the solution for the statements, and questions all you can answer very easily. See, this is another circular arrangement question. We have in this question, we have both facing center and outside. Okay, students Varun, Udit and Tarun are seated in a circle facing center. Agash, Bharati and Charu are also seated in the same circle, but two of them are not facing the center. So except two, all are facing center. Okay, that two are facing in the opposite direction. Varun is second to the left of Charu. See, they have given the hint like Varun, Udit and Tarun are facing center. So just look into the statement if anything is related to Varun, Udit and Tarun, because we know that they are facing center. So fixing them to one position, we can connect all that. See, Varun, Udit, there is no connection. Whereas Tarun, see, Bharati is third to the left of Tarun. So we can fix the position of Tarun facing inside, and third to left is Bharati. Okay. Now, Charu is second to the right of Tarun. So we can fix Charu also to second right of Tarun. Okay. Next, check for other statements. Varun is second to the left of Charu. So, we know that if Charu is facing inside, Varun cannot be fixed at second left. So, obviously, she is facing outside. Then, Udit is second to the right of Akash. See, again, Udit, we know he is facing center. So, second right of Akash. Akash also, you check if it is second left, can we fix the position? No. So, second right will face as Udit. And Akash is facing center. Then, Bharati is third to the left of Tarun. Charu is second to the right of Tarun. Akash is seated next to Varun. So, Akash's place also is fixed. The only other is Bharati. That also we'll fix. So, we'll answer the questions. Okay. So, I hope you all understood the concept. So, practice more questions and you'll finally end up with the right answers. So, thank you for supporting and keep watching for more videos. Thank you.